And which of these lines, blue, green, or red, is the one that's transversal to the other two? Means it goes, it intersects both of the lines. Cadence? Which one crosses both of the lines?
Blue.
Which line crosses the other two lines? The red, blue, or the green is the one that crosses, but it's transversal to the other two, yeah?
Green.
Green crosses both, okay? So, so blue and red aren't going to be perpendicular to each other, right? We can see that from the picture. Right? Okay, let me show you. Like, this would be the green one, right? It's doing something like this. The red one is doing something like this. Right? It's supposed to be red. Red's doing something like this, and blue is doing something like this, right? I don't know what the, you know, this might have to be a negative slope or something. But the green is going across both of these. Obviously, red and blue are not going to be perpendicular to each other, right? Do we agree on that?
Mm-hmm.
Good. If you agree with me, you're correct, which is always the case. So for the green line, we should figure out what its slope is. And then see if either the blue or the red line have slopes to tell us that those lines are perpendicular. So let's talk about the green line and how we find the slope. How do we find the slope of the green line? Well, really, any line. Slope of the green line. Sean? Josie?
Y minus y divided by x minus x.
Okay, and we just have to keep it consistent. Like, if I do this y negative 2, minus this y, negative 1, then I need to come back to this point again, right, for the first number. Negative 2 is first, and so down here 2 will be first, 2 minus negative 4. Negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1, and 2 plus 4 is 6, so you have a slope of negative 1 sixth. So a line that is perpendicular to this line will have what kind of a slope? What will its slope be if it's perpendicular to this line?
6 over 1.
Positive 6 over 1. So let's give it a whirl here. Let's take negative 3 minus 3, negative 3 minus 3, over negative 1 minus 0. Negative 3 minus 3 is negative 6. Negative 1 minus 0 is negative 1, which is equal to positive 6. So what can we say about blue and green?
They are perpendicular.
Okay, these guys are perpendicular. Let's see if red might also be perpendicular. Okay, so we do negative 3 minus 2, and already I stopped because why?
It's not 6.
Not 6. Or anything that can be simplified to 6. Right? Like if this came out to be 12, well, we keep going, because maybe the denominator would be 2, and then it would be 6 over 1. But it's 5, negative 5. It's never going to be 6, okay? Even if I simplify that fraction. So we can just rule it out. Okay, now number 8. You're always welcome to stop me if you had still had a question about it, the problem that I just did. You wouldn't stop me. Go on. All right, so let's see if you can color code this. You got the blue line. It has coordinates of 1, 1, and 5, negative 1. You got the red line. A little more red than that. Red line is negative 2, negative 2. And 2, negative 4. And the green line, it has 0.6. There we go. At 0, negative 4. And 3, 2. Okay. Anybody checking up on me? Is that all correct? Write those down correctly? Okay. So we can see here that the green line is sitting like this. The blue line is something like this, and the red line is something like that. So the blue line and the red line will not be perpendicular to each other. They might be perpendicular to the green line. So we should maybe start with the green line and see what its slope is, right? Someone walk me through the slope of the green line beside Sean. Grady?
2 minus 0.
Almost. It's two,
so I mean 2 minus -4.
2 minus -4, you got it. Over.
And then 3 minus 0.
That's right, 3 minus 0. So 2 minus -4 is going to be 2 plus 4, which is 6, over 3 minus 0, which is 3. 6 divided by 3 is 2. So a line that's perpendicular to this line will have what kind of a slope?
Negative 2.
Perpendicular? Did I say perpendicular? Perpendicular. A line that's perpendicular to this line will have what slope?
Negative 1 over 2?
Negative 1 over 2, right?
-1/2.
Opposite, reciprocal. This is 2/1. Opposite of that would be -1/2. The opposite of reciprocal would be -1/2. So that's what this would have to come out to be if it's going to be perpendicular. Right. -4 minus -2 over, so I did -4 first, so now I go 2 first, 2 minus -2. -4 plus 2 is -2. 2 plus 2 is 4. That's -1/2. So what do we say about these lines?
They're perpendicular.
You can even go like that, right? We know that they are perpendicular. They meet at a 90-degree angle. Except this guy here, it could also be perpendicular. -1 minus 1 over 5 minus 1. -1 minus 1 is -2. 5 minus 1 is 4. -1/2. So these are also perpendicular. Now, if these two lines are perpendicular to, they're both perpendicular to this line, then what does that say about these two lines?
They're parallel.
They're parallel. We also know that they're parallel because they're perpendicular to the same line, so they must be parallel, but they're also parallel because
they're the same rate of change.
Same rate of change, the same slope, the same delta y over delta x. Those things are the same. All right. That was 7 and 8. Next, G. y = 1/2 x - 1. Okay. So we're supposed to graph these, and we're supposed to determine what is the slope. And the point of intersection with the y-axis, I'll call that the y-intercept because that's what that's called. They gave it kind of a common sense layman definition, but now we have the official math word is or term is y-intercept. It's where the intercepts the y-axis. Really, this is kind of a reminder. We have already talked about this kind of thing and the patterns that arise when you write your equation like this. There's different ways to write the equation, but if you write it like this, certain patterns come about. Okay. Remember when we first started graphing these, we just started to think, what should I plug in for x? What would be easy to plug in for x? And what was always the easiest thing, Charlie?
2.
Super good choice. Because it's the same as the denominator, right? So 1/2 times 2 over 1 minus 1. 1/2 times 2 is?
2/2.
Yeah, 2/2, which is 1. And 1 minus 1 is?
0.
So 2 gives us a 0. But is there even easier thing to plug in for x?
0.
0 is even easier. So I'd say this is first place for easiness, and second place for easiness. Because when you plug in a 0, this term gets eliminated, and we just want to put a -1. I don't even need to think about writing down that work. So 0, -1. So we can start here. What's the y-intercept? Where does it cross the y-axis? Sean?
-1.
A -1 right there. I just put it down there, right? It crosses at -1. y = -1, or we could even put 0, -1, all those are fine. Okay? Is this gonna be a line?
Mm-hmm.
How are you? How can you be so sure it's gonna be a line? Okay, there's no exponents. We talked about that before. I kind of just gave it away, right? Spoiled it for you. If there's no exponents on the x, right? I kind of oversimplified it there, but most times that means it's going to be a line. It's going to be a line. Okay? How about every time I plug in something that is, what kind of number do we like to put in for x in this case?
2.
And?
0.
And?
1.
We like 1?
Mm-hmm.
1's not great. What's another really nice one? Is that?
4,
Charlie, another one?
-2.
-6, we're starting
eight.
Okay, numbers that what?
Are
even.
A multiple.
Divide by
two. Multiple of 2, you can divide by 2, have a factor of 2 that in oversimplified terms, the 2 cancels with that number, okay? And every time we plug in, say, the next multiple of 2, right, then we just add on another 1, right? If I go to the next multiple of 2, well, that's going to give me, we're at 4, so 2, we got 1 over 2 times 4 over 1. Well, now this 2, when it cancels the 4, leaves a 2 times 1, right? So we add 2, 1, 2. Is 1 up from where the previous point was. If I go over another 2, right, how many do I go up from here?
1.
I go up 1 more. Right? That is what we call, what is that pattern of going over 2 and up 1? The rate of change. It's also called what?
Slope.
Anybody think of another name for it?
Delta Y
or delta X. Okay, all these things being the same, they all have. Well, in this case, they're calling for it by name of slope. What's the slope of this line?
1 over 2.
1 over 2. Remember, it is the vertical change, delta y, over the horizontal change, delta x. If I go from here to this point, I go up, right? Up is positive, to the right is positive, 2 positive numbers, up 1, to the right 2, slope of 1/2. Delta y over delta x. Plot all of these infinite points, but I don't have infinite time, so I just go ahead and cheat by drawing a line. Right. Questions? Do you see a pattern here? Like, can you look at this equation and see something about the answers that we gave on the table? What do you see? You look at the equation, does it tell you any of this information?
Yeah.
No, what does it tell you?
Everything.
Everything, yeah. You just look at it and you know that the slope is what?
1/2.
It's 1/2. We know that that pattern is going to happen because we know that the numbers that we want to plug in for x are going to be 2, 4, 6, right? We're going to go over in steps of 2, and every time we go over 2, we go up 1. That's exactly what the slope is. It's right there. And this is what?
Y-intercept.
The y-intercept, because we know we're going to cross the y-axis when x equals
0.
And when x is 0, look, the only x term right is right there. The only other anything that's in this equation is -1. So -1 will be left when you plug in 0. It's just sitting there right in front of your faces, the slope and the y-intercept. So let's do h. Y equals -1/2 x -1. Let's go backwards this time. Give our answers and notice that the work proves that we're right. So what would be the y-intercept of this graph? Try it.
-1.
What would be the slope of this graph? Great.
-1/2.
Excellent. Okay. Well, I don't even do any work. I just say I know what the y-intercept is, right? It's -1. Let's put a point there. I know what the slope is. It's -1/2, which means I either need to think of it as -1/2 or 1/-2. Let me show you what I mean by that. here I think of the vertical as negative, here I think of the horizontal as negative. Let's do this one first. Down one is what I'm saying there, down one, and to the right two. Down one and to the right two. So we're losing something. The container is emptying of water. We're, you know, our money is going away. We're losing weight. Whatever it is, it's going down over time. If I go to this interpretation of the slope, I can go up one and then negative horizontally. What's negative horizontally?
To the left.
So we go up one and we go to the left two. Looks a lot like this line, only it has opposite slope. Not the opposite reciprocal, just the opposite. Okay. Well, I think that's what it should look like because I know the y-intercept and I know the slope. We're just going to confirm this by doing the math real quick. It'll take about 10 seconds. X is 0 means y is what?
Negative 1.
0 there, negative 1 there. Plug in a what for x? 2 is a good choice because 2 will cancel with this 2. Negative 1 half times 2 over 1 minus 1. So negative 1 half times 2 is negative 2 over positive 2. So that's negative 1 minus 1, negative 2. Let's see if that works. 0, negative 1. There it is. That's the point I already plotted just based on that. 2 for x, negative 2 for y. 2 for x, negative 2 for y. We were right. Okay? You see the pattern we're trying to draw out of there. This is what we call the slope-intercept form. If you take a look back in your notes, I may have already mentioned that. But maybe not. There it is. It's in slope-intercept form because it gives you the slope and the y-intercept. Just, it's right there. It's on a silver platter. Here they are. And that's enough information to graph the line without really having to do any plugging in of x's. Did you have to know that to do this table? Did you have to know the slope-intercept form and that you can pull the slope and the y-intercept out of it? Say no, I didn't have to know that. What could you have done if you didn't know that? Plug some stuff in and get some points and connect those points with the line. Absolutely. Okay. I didn't already, but I should have. Had you pass your homework in, go ahead and pass your homework in. And at the same time, get your desks cleared off. Okay, so the question is, are these parallel, perpendicular, or neither? So how do we find out which is which and what is parallel or perpendicular? Find the slope of each line. Okay, so let's find the slope of A. The slope of A. How do we find it? Ready?
3 minus 5.
Okay.
And 5 minus 8.
5 minus 8. Just make sure you keep that order the same, right? 3 comes first, so 5 comes first. 3 comes first, so 5 comes first. The first ones come to the same point. 3 minus 5 is negative 2. 5 minus 8 is negative 3. So positive 2/3. B. Say this expense negative 5 minus negative 2. 8 then minus 10. Negative 5 plus 2 is negative 3. 8 minus 2, or sorry, 8 minus 10 is negative 2. Negative 5, no, it's it. Yeah, negative 5 plus 2 is negative 3. 8 minus 10. 8 minus 10 is negative 2. So 3 halves. So what is it?
Parallel.
2/3.
Neither.
3/2.
Neither.
Are they the same?
No.
Nope, they're not both 2/3. They're not both 3/2. Are they reciprocals?
No.
Reciprocals?
Well, yes.
They are reciprocals. Are they opposite reciprocals?
No.
No, they have to be both, so they're neither. Okay. A little bit of a trick question. Trick questions are good. We learn from them. We learn, oh yeah, they have to not just be 2/3 and 3/2, but 2/3 and negative 3/2, or negative 2/3 and positive 3/2. Moving on. We can just do this one right on this page. What's the slope of this line?
5/7.
5/7. So Shout it out. That's the that's what we call m. Okay, m is the letter that we give to the slope. For well, no reason that I'm aware of. Cadence, what is the y-intercept?
0, -4. 0, -4.
Very good. 0, -4. If you said -4, if you said y = -4, all those are fine. Okay. So this is the y-intercept. I bet most people would write -4. So m is the letter that we, you know, the name of the slope. E is the name of the y-intercept. Okay. Really, your homework here, 2.3. It's like more of what you did on that sheet, on that worksheet. But now we know the little shortcuts, right? But be aware, if your equation doesn't look like this, specifically y by itself, only y on this side equals mx plus b, if it doesn't look exactly like that, the shortcut doesn't work. That's okay. You can make it look exactly like that. For instance, if you had y minus 5 equals 3x, does this look like that?
No.
What's that? Add 5 to both sides. Now we got y by itself. It looks like this. Y equals 3x plus 5. Now it does look like that. Now it is ready for you to just say the slope is?
3.
And the y-intercept is?
5.
So, here we go. No problem. Now what? Tell me a story. Tell me a story that fits this equation.
That's right.
So what? Tell me a story that goes with this equation. Just about 2 minutes. We have 2 minutes to come up with a story. Sean? No? Halfway, Sean?
Halfway.
Sean?
Okay, you earned $3 per week and you started out with $5.
Nice. $3 per week, right? It's important that it's a per because that's a
rate
of change. Very good. So we got a rate right here. That rate could be anything. Look for rates. There's going to be stories with rates in them. Okay? And, quote, starting points. Okay? Start with $5. That's our starting point. That's right on the y-axis. Very good. Okay, so make sure you got the homework written down and questions.